We've been told that blue light is dangerous for our health. But my question is, do we need to protect our skin from it? Hello, my successful and healthy earthlings, Mihaela Răguș here, naturopath and founder of the Natural Health Podcast. In this episode today, you will learn if there is a need to protect your skin from blue light. I'm going to go through and discuss what blue light is, and I'm going to go through and then answer the question, is there a need to protect your skin from blue light? And then I'm going to give you three tips on how to work with blue light for optimal health. And at the end of this episode, I'm going to give you an opportunity to join a success and health-oriented community by joining the Natural Health Newsletter by clicking the link below. Welcome to the Natural Health Podcast, where we bring awareness of sustainable health in the business hustle space. The Natural Health Podcast is perfect for the high-performing business-minded individuals who want to work with their biochemistry to achieve success and optimal health. It's Mondays with Mihaela. That's right, me. Thank you so much for tuning in. Absolutely love, 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 and appreciate your support. On Mondays, I'm here to provide you simple, savvy, and sustainable health hacks to optimize your health. In today's episode, I want to be talking about blue light. There's been so much information out there about blue light and how dangerous it is for us, right? So much information out there, like I said, and I can have an argument saying that blue light is dangerous, yes, and I can have another argument saying that blue light is actually beneficial, right? It's so much to it. It always depends what your goal is and what you're trying to achieve. But let's have a look at what is blue light, okay? So blue light is part of the visible light spectrum with waves out of about 415 nm to 495 nm. Blue light can be divided into two bands, right? We've got blue violet light, and then we have blue turquoise light. Not all blue light is harmful. In fact, two bands of light mentioned above, blue violet and blue turquoise, exhibit vastly different effects on the eyes. Okay, let's look into the blue turquoise light first, okay? So besides helping the visual activity, contrast, acuity, and color vision, blue turquoise light is essential for our pupillary reflex and the synchronization of our circadian rhythm, which I always talk about, which in turn helps to maintain and regulate memory, mood, and hormonal balance, and so many other things that I've spoken about. And if you want to know more, check out my episodes on the circadian rhythm. Light of this wavelength plays a vital role in maintaining our general health. So this light, blue turquoise light, can be beneficial to our health as it regulates the circadian rhythm, which controls our sleep-wake cycle. It is an essential for, you know, our, like I said, our hormones, our memory, our restful night sleep, for everything to function the way it is supposed to function, okay? It can even boost brain activity, improve memory, mood, alertness, and mental performance. So many things. Now let's look at blue violet light. As with UV rays, overexposure to blue violet light can harm your eyes. It can damage the retina and potentially increase of risk diseases such as age-related molecular dendrosis, sunburned corneal, which is photokeratosis, which can also lead to temporary blindness. So it just depends. See what I mean by people saying, oh, blue light's bad for you, blue light's good for you. Well, which light? Let's go into a little bit more detail. When is it? Is it natural? Is it artificial? What time of the day are we having it? And so forth, okay? During the day, 25 to 30% of sunlight is composed of blue light, but there are many other sources of blue violet light. Modern lighting, including LED lights and compact fluorescent lamps, although bright and energy efficient, which, you know, I don't know about you guys, but I think here in Australia, in Victoria, there's people going around saying, hey, let's change your lights to fluorescent lamps. They're energy efficient. Okay. But are they actually beneficial for me? Right? They can be a strong source of harmful blue light. 35% of LED light and 25% of light from CLFs, which is the fluorescent lamps, consist of harmful blue light. The cooler or whiter the light, the higher the proportion of blue light emitted, right? Other sources, as you know, include our laptops, our TVs, smartphones, tablets, other electronic devices, okay? But the question that I've got here, now that you know a little bit about what blue light is and there's different types of blue lights, and I'm not even a light expert. Imagine, you know what? I should actually probably get a light expert on the Natural Health Podcast. If you know a light expert, let them come and join Natural Health Podcast. So The question is there a need to protect your skin from blue light? And the reason how I came about this episode is there was a study done in May 2021, so literally a few months ago, and the study looked at blue light, okay? The recent academic and commercial concern expressed about adverse effects in the skin from violet and blue light exposure goes beyond the well-known effects of UV. So the aims of the study were they wanted to qualify exposure to violet and blue light to selected sources applied for lightning, medical procedures, as well as the sun. They wanted to compare the levels with literature for the effects on the skin. They wanted to estimate the exposure time, the maximum exposure time of blue light to avoid possible adverse effects. They wanted to compare the blue light maximum exposure to solar radiation. And I wanted to address the question whether protection of the skin against blue violet light may be appropriate, and if so, for which population group and condition, okay? So let's go look into it. So light sources from concerns are typically indoor lightning, electronic scenes, and sun. Unlike solar radiation, the International Agency for Research on Cancer does not classify fluorescent lightning as carcinogenic to humans yet. Do you like how I put that yet there? So this agency currently, with the current research and what they've gone currently, doesn't classify fluorescent lightning as a carcinogenic to humans yet. It may, okay? Issues. Since visible light can be absorbed to the skin, our skin, and may have effect, it may affect connective tissue and pigment cells, it is likely that certain exposure levels may influence appears and structure in terms of reduced elasticity and change in pigmentation. That's a bit of a concern. But let's look at what was the actual conclusion. The study is a big study. Let's look at the conclusion, what they concluded, okay, in this one study. Based on literature studies, exposure assessments, and unknown weighting functions for skin effects, they concluded the following. Violet blue light emissions doses from selected domestic sources, electronic screens, and medical operating light were lower than dose reported to induce observational effect on the skin with particular exposure times. So they were lower, but imagine if someone exposes themselves a lot more than this study has. The UV component of solar radiations causes skin damage in shorter time than that of violet blue light. So the UV component of solar radiation causes skin damage in shorter time, so quicker, but that doesn't mean that violet blue light doesn't, it just takes longer. So the application of violet blue light absorbing sunscreen is not needed, that's what they're saying, okay? They're saying in this study, the exposure time is slower, so there's no need to put sunscreen on when you're inside, or some type of sunscreen on inside when you're exposed to violet blue light. Exception may be for patients suffering from photosensitive diseases or taking photosensitive medication. There are so many individuals on photosensitive medication. It is extraordinary. And so many individuals who may have photosensitive diseases. So this is interesting, this study. It's saying, essentially it's saying we don't need to protect ourselves yet with the time that they've exposed it. But the question is, it says it does it in a shorter time, our UV radiation. But imagine, what I've got to ask is, imagine yourself. You are working in an office. I know I have lights on me right now, but individuals that are working in the office have this fluorescent light on them maybe 10 hours a day, 5 days a week. That's 50 hours you're exposed to it. How much are we told to cover our skin in the sun, okay? Which only produces, I think it was 30% of this blue light. We're told to cover ourselves, okay? Yes, it has different types of radiation and so forth, but just think about it, okay? That is only one study. But with us checking our phones an average of 150 times a day, and a 2019 report finding most on average spent 3 hours and 50 minutes on our phones every day, with the top 20% of smartphone users having daily screen time in excess of 4.5 hours, we are significantly getting more blue light exposure than we have ever or from the sun alone. Blue light causes potential skin harm with free radical generation, as blue light has been shown in studies to induce oxidative stress in live skin, which can promote skin aging. Blue light also compromises our beauty sleep, as you would like to say, as it impacts our circadian rhythm. And if we're exposed to a lot of blue light, it definitely affects our body clock. Okay, so there's so many things to take in consideration. At the end of the day, I gave you two different views. I gave you a view of blue light is not a carcinogenic yet for our skin, and we don't have to protect ourselves yet unless you're taking those medications or you're photosensitive, okay, or you're exposing yourself a lot of the time to blue light. The other side said that we're spending so much time in front of blue light that we're not even seeing the sun. And not only that, the other side took it and said, we are actually exposing our skin so much that it's actually impacting not even just our skin, but our circadian rhythm, which is effectively affecting our skin because it causes free radicals in our body and oxidation. So what the question I have for you is how long are you spending under fluorescence lights? Okay. Is it impacting your skin? What is your goal? Are you actually going outside to see the actual sun, the natural blue light? That is my question to you. But now let's go into three tips on how to work with blue light for optimal health. Number one is expose yourself to natural blue light in the morning first thing, because what does that do? Yes, it resets our circadian rhythm, kicks off our master clock and all of our organ clocks into generation straight away, which is then able to deal with the free radicals of the oxidation, and our hormones levels are able to balance themselves and everything just works amazingly, okay? Number two is reduce blue light exposure at night. Blue light from all of these things right in front of me, from the light, from the phone, from the TV, from anything, remove that blue light. It does not serve you. Number three is in your office, use natural light, okay? Sit next to a window. There's no need to turn on the light in the office if it is sunny outside. Use the natural light to give you light, okay? So there you have it. Three tips on how to work with blue light for optimal health. And in the meantime, keep an eye out on your research that might be coming out if blue light is actually dangerous for your skin, because there is some things showing it is and some things that aren't, not yet classified as a carcinogenic. So do you want to wait until it is classified as a carcinogenic, or do you want to be proactive? That's my question to you. So there you have it. Blue light, dangerous for skin, I would say so. But, you know, it's for you to make a choice and be proactive about your health. So there you have it. A lot of information about blue light and your skin and exactly what you can do to assist yourself. If you know someone who absolutely loved this episode, share this episode with them. Comment below and let me know how much blue light exposure you are having and what your thoughts are on the damage it may have on your skin. And if you want to join our health and success oriented community, please click the newsletter below. You will be sent bonuses from our guests, special offers from our products, and the latest research to optimize your health and success so your business can boom absolutely amazingly. Because you know why? Because you're going to be on point. You're going to be healthy. The number one asset in your business is going to be healthy. So your business kicks it off. Okay. And remember, the missing link between failure and success is your health. Content and information provided here is the opinion of Mahela Raguse and is for information purposes only and does not constitute medical advice. It is not intended to provide medical advice or take the place of medical advice or any current treatment you're undertaking. Consult your own medical professionals for any medical issues that you may be having. This entire disclaimer also applies to any guests or contributors to the Natural Health Podcast. It is advised that you consult your doctor or healthcare professional in relation to any health concerns you may be having. Mahela Raguse does not take responsibility for any health consequences which occur from a person listening, viewing, or reading this content. Under no circumstances shall the Natural Health Podcast, Mahela Raguse, any guests or contributors to the Natural Health Podcast, or any employees, associates, or affiliates of Mahela Raguse be responsible for damages arising from the information provided on the Natural Health Podcast. By listening to this podcast, you agree not to use this podcast as medical advice to treat any medical conditions in either yourself or others. Please note, if you're taking prescription, do not stop your medication or start a new protocol, including but not limited to supplements, diet, lifestyle changes, without consulting a doctor or healthcare professional. If you or any person
has a medical concern, you should consult with your healthcare provider or seek other professional medical advice. Never disregard professional medical advice or delay in seeking it because of something that you have read or heard on the Naturopath podcast or in any linked materials. If you think you may have a medical emergency, call your doctor or emergency services immediately. Neither Mihaela Rugus nor the publisher of this context takes responsibility for the possible health consequences of any person or persons reading or listening or following the information in the educational content.